question for you. Get down. Down. Good boy. Yes. Good boy.
I'm holding out for Steve.
Go back next door.
Well, that was, Jesse brought snakes last week. They weren't very good, but they tasted, they had a good flavor. I mean, he did a good job of seasoning and stuff. And so there was a chunk left of James's steak that had like a kind of a line and drizzle through the middle of it. Mm-hmm. So there wasn't really a way you could really cut like around it, you know? So he left it on his plate. So I cut it up into small pieces and put it in the dog's food. And all three of them were like, oh dear God, this is amazing. Leo would eat a bite and he'd look at me like, what is this magic? He's never had steak, I don't think. Is that cool? Oh my gosh. This isn't my last day, is it?
Good.
Striker. Leave it. Hey.
No, you don't like to me because sometimes
I have a problem with homeless dog. I
think yes. Sometimes you have to know. We gotta come up with a name for this dog.
I know. Hey. No. No. Good boy.
Because like if you meet somebody outside, what are you going to say? This is no name.
No name yet.
Huh? You can't say that.
It reminds me of a scene Elsie from Friends where they were trying to come up with a name for the baby. I think it was Ross and Rachel's baby. And they both agreed that they had veto rights. So they're both throwing out names. And she's like, veto. And then he started doing it. And then Phoebe says, is it just me or is it Vito starting to sound good? Yeah, Vito Geller, it just rolls right off the tongue.
No, you must stay.
Stay.
Baxter. Stay. Baxter's good.
He said, okay, I stayed. Good boy.
What do you say?
Huh? What?
Baxter's good. I like Baxter.
Yeah, that's a cute name.
Mm-hmm. You just need to go back to packing the name.
Yeah.
You know, if you stay on the skyline past Orange Grove and keep going up towards Ina, there's a road on the left and it's in Spanish, but it literally translates to street with no name. Mm-hmm. Like, it's something like Paseo or Calle sin nombre. And I'm like, you guys didn't even try. Like,
exactly.
Like, just because you put it in Spanish, like, you didn't even try.
There'd be part of your anus. There'd be part of your anus. Not on mine.
Funny that his sister, or whatever she is to him, corrects other dogs for getting too close because they both have space issues.
Right.
You have no boundaries, do you?
No.
What do you think about this place, huh? It's not bad, is it?
That's how I do it.
No, he's really not.
Thank you.
after 15 minutes. This feels pretty good, huh, bud? I told that I used to pay Garrett when he was a little kid. He used to pay him to scratch my back. I give him a dollar. He's like, I think that's enough for a dollar. I said, no, a little bit more. I'll give you $1.50. He goes, No, Fletcher, leave it. There good boy, Fletch. Good job, buddy.
Yeah, very good.
I love seeing her come back in here with her tail.
Let me see her.
That's the coolest thing.
Let me see.
That is the coolest thing to see. That's what I was telling you about.
Yeah, let me see this. Let me see this. Let me see this.
I was telling her what they were like. I said last meeting, her first Sunday here. I said,
oh, Jesus. Excuse me, Hayesburg. Excuse me. Yes, I know. I love you too. Yes, very good boy. Yes, you're very good boy. Let's just get a leash off. Come on. Let's get a leash off.
He's so obnoxious. He sits on her head.
Right?
Somebody went in to see them yesterday, and he sat down on the couch, and she was up on the couch. So this goofball comes up and literally sits on her head. And she's like looking like this sideways. And like, and she just, it doesn't even cross her mind to get upset about it. She's just like, I'll just wait until he's done.
He is something to look at this guy.
Stryker woke up. First of God.
I'm a guy. I'm a guy.
Okay.
Ooh.
Why did you guys choose Dash? You can find out.
Oh, that's
trying try to get out of his kennel.
Oh, God.
Okay. I can't believe you live in this thing all the time. Doesn't it drive you crazy?
It's like wearing a bra all day long.
I know.
Yes.
A lot of the dogs do it packed, though.
Do they?
Yep.
What's your name? What is your name?
Probably bothers me more than it does him.
Huh? What about more than this guy? What's his name? John.
His name is Dash.
Oh, yeah.
That's cute.
Yeah.
What's
that?
Dash.
I kind of like Dash a lot.
Yeah, I kind of do, too. I kind of think it works.
Yeah.
Okay, Dash.
Door Dash.
Hi.
Okay, little Dash.
Okay,
you are good. Good.
Did you take a nap today? Huh?
Did I?
Did you get a nap?
I didn't get one yet.
handsome boy.
Is the black one here?
You're just
dead
so quiet
now
that there's nobody
to yell
at.
Okay.
Can
you?
No,
oh,
there's just
who is
no,
now
so
Dash.
Quiet.
Is she going to be Dash then?
Yeah,
I
Dash.
Can't do a
okay.
With the shelter.
He's a good boy.
I'd take you know, home
Dash.
If I could.
She's got a name.
Or Dash.
Oh, no.
Dash. Yeah.
You know, oh, God bless you. You got another one coming?
Yeah, put
your
paper.
Yeah.
Okay, just open your mouth. You had too much.
You just kind of collapsed on me.
You're done, buddy. You're done, my good boy.
All they have their personalities are all just so different. Oh, Sparky's eating. It's good. How come you didn't eat?
He must have been an electrician that
time. Does he eat at the shelter?
No.
This guy, Fletch.
Usually if you can get him,
No.
No, but usually if you can get him eating something else, then suddenly he gets interested in food. It's kind of funny how that works with him, but...
You're not skinny.
Not anymore. You're going to be 2 times a day. Look.
Mmm.
Look at
Stretch.
Okay, buddy. That hard to eat the primer aloud.
Because he didn't eat much. He must have ate before he came. Okay?
Possibly.
Well, he had a bunch of goodies with me.
Good.
So maybe he's full.
Sometimes it works with him. Not always, but a lot. A lot of times it does.
Oh, look at you, you handsome girl.
Oh, Soren, sitting here looking so handsome.
I think the best thing that could have happened for him is that he got confiscated and brought back.
Oh, yeah.
It's giving him the best chance of finding a good owner and not a shit that he's been dealt with up to this point.
I think he just didn't want to help him.
Bonnie, when we were walking them,
yeah,
she didn't seem nearly as concerned as where he was as last week.
That's awesome.
She was like leading.
I was talking to volunteers yesterday, and I said one of the things that has started happening, and I didn't do it intentionally, but it's now happened with 4. Sorry, there you are. I'm like, wait, that's not your voice. But it's now happened with 4 sets of dogs.
Uh-huh.
Lily and Lassie, Regina and Becky, now these 2, and those 2. Where one of them was much more like needy.
Mm-hmm.
The other one was very sociable with people. And by them coming up here, they were here. The confident one was here just long enough, because they were the first ones that went with each of the dogs. But they were here just long enough to help the other one come out of their shell. I don't think if the guy who took Regina, I don't think if he had met her 3 weeks ago, I don't think he would have been as impressed.
Mm-hmm.
She was so pretty shut down.
Yeah. Yeah.
But being in this environment, it's so transformative for them.
Yeah.
You know? And the other thing is it's been great. I've had conversations with Kathy Newman because she's not thrilled with me because most of they've all been split up. But it's a really good example of how just because they come in together, it doesn't necessarily mean that they should or they need to stay
together.
Yeah,
they don't have to stay.
They need to come out of their shell is what they need.
Yeah.
And that's what's happened with her in this, just in a week's time.
Yeah.
And with Lily, Lily was a different dog. And the really cool thing about Lily's adoption was Mike, who, he helped us like with our move and everything. He was doing adoptions. The Tuesday that she got adopted, and this guy came in and was looking for like an older chow. He had just lost his a while back, and blah blah blah. So when he brought Lily out to meet him, he was like, "Oh, she's such a nice dog." He says, "Yeah, but let me tell you about her." So the cool thing is like there's a lot of volunteers now at PAC that are helping with adoptions that get to know these dogs because they're also doing stuff for TRN. And so he told him, he said, "I load dogs for them, you know, multiple times a week." He said, "And the first time he interacted with her, she didn't want anybody really."